Cup. Holtz long lead feed ahead to Vincent Byron. Going to rush a pass and ball scores!
Hello everyone, I'm Andy Liu from Future Consideration, and today we'll take a closer look at 2019 NHL Draft top prospect, Bowen Byram. Byram is considered by most as the best defenseman eligible for the upcoming NHL Draft, and rightfully so, after a great D-1 season, posting a 0.45 points per game, he stepped up his game this year with now up to 59 points in 59 games for a perfect 1 point per game. But let's forget about stats for a moment. How does Byram stands up on the ice? Let's look at every aspect of his game. That means his skating, shooting, passing, stick handling, defensive game, physicality, hockey IQ and competitiveness. Let's start with the skating. Byram moves the puck up the ice with such ease. He always has the head up, which allows him to adapt to what's in front of him and create multiple control zone entries. He is such a smooth skater and he dodges opponents seamlessly. The left-handed defenseman has a great stride and an excellent second gear that he loves to use to surprise his opponent. He has some quick feet that allows him to move around the zone effortlessly. He is very confident with the puck on his stick and won't hesitate to join the attack. He is not the fastest skater, but using excellent passes to open the play allows him to get in the back of the defense without trouble. Like I said, could work on his speed, but outside of that, he's just such a complete skater that I will have to give him 5 stars. Might seem a reach to some, but I'm a big fan of this aspect of his game. Let's pass to his shooting. Byram has a decent shot. It's not the most powerful or dangerous, but it's almost always on goal, which generates rebounds and scoring chances for his teammate. His slap shot can still surprise goalies, and he owns a good release on his wrist shot. Most of his goals doesn't necessarily come from an excellent shot, but rather his great positioning, offensive awareness, and even stick handling. That said, he still owns a good shot, and I'll have to give him nothing less than a 4 stars. Let's now discuss about his passing. Byram is an excellent passer. He owns one of, if not the best breakout pass of any draft eligible. He always has the head up to look at his option, and his decision making is excellent. He finds teammate quickly under pressure and makes just wonderful passes on the tape almost every time. In the offensive zone, he distributes the puck well and makes every detail right, like moving away from his teammate before sending them the puck to make the goalie and defense move away from the shot. His poise at the blue line is also excellent. I would give him 5 stars. Let's now look at his stick handling. Byram got some slick hands. He rarely pulls out flashy dangles, but he loves to use his quick mitts to make his way through the defense. His stick handles with the head up and passes opponent with such ease, seeing them coming from miles away. He can also make room for himself to get a shot to the net and escape pressure with the puck. I would give him 4 stars. Let's pass to his defensive game. Byram has a great gap control and active stick that makes him super tough to pass in rushes. He doesn't let anyone cut to the net too. He possesses a great first pass and is able to restart the attack after making a defensive play so quickly. He reads plays quickly and can make breakout passes under pressure. He makes good decisions in all situations. I would give him 4 stars. Let's now discuss about his physicality. Byram is 6'1" and weighs 192 pounds according to Elite Prospect. Byram is not a physical defenseman and rarely goes out of his way to throw a hit like this one, as he prefers to focus on his good positioning. He still does a good job winning board battles and defending against speedy forward trying to cut to the net. He has a good balance and owns a decent strength. I would give Byram 3 stars. Let's now look at his hockey IQ. Byram is the smartest defenseman of this draft. He reads the play super well and makes great decisions quickly. He looks to exploit every breach in the defense. He always has the head up carrying the puck to look at every option and adjust to his opponent's positioning. He might have a great skating and vision, but it's his great decision making that helps him create so many control zone entries. After moving the puck up the ice, he loves to open the play to create even more space for himself. The Canadian defenseman sees plays developing quickly and knows when to support the attack. He's creative and prefers to adjust his positioning as the play goes on. He loves to move away from his teammate before sending them the puck to make the goalie and defense move away from the shot. With his great vision, he sees when there's open ice to be exploited and never hesitates to jump into the action. Baron talks to his teammate on the ice when decision needs to be taken. He does everything right. He easily gets a 5 stars. Let's finish by looking at his competitiveness. Baron doesn't lack intensity by any means, but he's certainly not a competitive player. He puts efforts defending and you'll see highlight of great perseverance on defensive play. But outside of that, he's more of a smooth, effortless skater than an aggressive and competitive player. It's not a knock on his game by any means, but I will have to give him 3 stars. So in conclusion, Baram is a smart, puck mover, playmaking defenseman. He's very complete in every aspect of the game and doesn't seem to have a single weakness. Future consideration has Baram at the 4th spot in their most recent ranking, and I think that's a fair ranking. Anyway, what's your opinion on Bowen Baram? Is he the best defenseman eligible for the upcoming NHL draft, or am I wrong and he shouldn't get that much praise? Let me know in the comments below. Subscribe for more NHL draft related videos and click here to see my previous scouting report on 2019 eligible. I'll see you for the next one. Fear not, here I come, you can't hide. Ready or not, here I come.